Hypervisor debugging with the TRACE32 JTAG debugger. Lauterbach provides since 2016 high-performance hypervisor debug support through the named Hypervisor Awareness, which is an extension that Lauterbach provides for its debuggers. The extensions for particular hypervisors are created by Lauterbach and provided to its customers. The most important objective of the TRACE32 Hypervisor Awareness is a seamless debugging of the overall system. This means that when the system has stopped at a breakpoint, you can check and change the current state of every single process, all virtual machines, plus the current state of the hypervisor and of the real hardware platform. In addition, you can set a program breakpoint at any location in the code. Lauterbach currently provides debug extensions for the following hypervisors. We use in this video a TRACE32 power review for ARM release of September 2018 together with a Power Debug Pro connected to a Renesas Aircar H3 board which has 4 Cortex-A53 and 4 Cortex-A57 cores. In this video, I will present some key TRACE32 features for hypervisor debugging. Our system includes the following: a Zen hypervisor with 3 GIS on top of it, a Linux, the so-called DOM 0, which does all the administration work. GIS 2 is an AUTOSAR adaptive platform based on Linux. GIS 3 is an Erica operating system. Please note that our demo uses only the 4 Cortex-57 cores. Zen and all guest operating systems are already running on my target. I'm using the following script to establish the debug communication with an SMP system consisting of the 4 Cortex-A57 cores and prepare hypervisor debugging. First, I load the TRACE32 debug extension for the hypervisor Zen. Zen-aware debugging requires that the debug symbol for the hypervisor are loaded. As part of the setup process, the TRACE32 default menu is extended by Zen menu, which provides access to all important hypervisor-specific TRACE32 commands. Then the script does the setup for the guest operating systems by loading the operating system awarenesses one after the other, and we also compile menu extensions for each guest. I will now start the script. The debug symbols are loaded by the debugger, which takes some time. For this reason, I'm increasing the video speed here. Now let's start with the hypervisor aware debugging. The first important comment is the comment task list machines, which provides details about all virtual machines and guest operating systems running on our target. The hypervisor itself has the machine ID 0. By selecting the menu Zen, Display Task Tree, we can open the hierarchical view of all processes running on our system. The flat view of the same information is provided by the task list tasks command. TRACE32 Power View can display the context of any task, even inactive tasks. Just double-click on the task name. We can see, for instance, from the stack frame window that this task is waiting for its next execution. If you are interested in details on what is currently running on the individual cores, use Zen Display Core Activity. Let's resume the program execution. We see messages printed in the terminal window coming from the Erica operating system as well as the adaptive platform. I will stop now the program execution. As you can see from the core activity window, core 1 is executing the Erica operating system while the other cores are in the Zen hypervisor. Let's now set a breakpoint in the adaptive platform process printing the messages. To do so, I will select the menu View, Symbols, Browse Functions. Browse the main function of the HHMCom process and set a breakpoint in the following loop. The same way, I will set a breakpoint in the idle function of the Erica operating system task printing the messages. Now, if I restart the program execution, I will stop in the adaptive platform process. The current core is core 0. If I restart again, then I will stop in the Erica operating system task. TRACE32 Hypervisor-aware debugging allows additionally the display of the resources of the guest operating systems. Now let's look at the menus for the guests. We can display, for instance, the kernel modules loaded by DOM 0, the device tree blob of the adaptive platform, or the alarms of the Erica operating system. This is all I wanted to show you in this video. Please refer for more details to the following links. Thank you for watching.